Peter MacKay is running for the leadership of the Federal Conservative Party. He was in Thunder Bay today, and he was greeted going to the Finlandia Club by protesters over comments that he has made on social media. Here's the story. This is James with NetNewsLedger in Thunder Bay.
Welcome to Thunder Bay, Peter.
Thank you, James. It's great to be here. Loving the time here in Thunder Bay.
Have they got you your Finn pancakes yet?
Not yet, but there's still time. We were here for the Special Olympics that are taking place here, and Thunder Bay's just done a magnificent job in hosting, and the athletes and coaches and parents are having a great time, I assure you.
It was a spectacular opening ceremony. Getting into the political game, you're coming back in.
That's right.
You've been having a little fun on social media. That led to a group outside of Indigenous and other protesters saying that you've got to ramp down the rhetoric. What message would you share with Chief Collins and Grand Chief Fiddler?
Well, let's talk. Let's get together and work out what the real issues are. And what I fear is happening is the protests that block railways, that interfere with people's lives, that in fact are preventing the commerce of the nation from happening, is getting in the way of actual productive discussions. And we reached back in order to try to facilitate that discussion. And nobody's saying that people don't have a right to protest and express themselves, but people do have a right in this country as well to be able to move their goods, especially when it's critical medicine and propane and resources that have to get to market. That's not part of what I would call a useful dialogue.
I think the concern for them, what they were saying, is that you were applauding individuals who are working outside of police or any effective engagement with the state in dismantling borders.
No,
that was the concern they were expressing.
Well, that concern, I think, is real. If people were being confrontational, if people were advocating violence, or if people were in any way being violent, that's not at all what I was advocating. I simply acknowledged that in one instance, people went and removed debris that was on a railway. And that, to me, is not a bad thing. It's not confrontational. It's not violent. It didn't lead to any kind of, you know, interaction other than they removed the debris, and I simply acknowledge that.
Right. So it's not. So it's not the job of the state then to do that if people are blockading.
Well, it is the job of the state,
okay.
And that's exactly what we need to have happen. And we've seen this inaction, quite frankly, for almost 3 weeks now. The government has been sending very mixed and muddled signals. The police, I think, are caught in between. They want to do their job, and yet they're feeling perhaps that the government doesn't have their back in this instance. And so nobody's saying no to dialogue. Nobody is saying that we shouldn't have these discussions. What we have seen is, I think, another agenda attach itself to the very legitimate issues and discussions that are taking place with our First Nations. And let's not forget, let's go back to basic principles, the Wet'suwet'en people have spoken through their elected band council, and in fact, I believe it is the majority of the hereditary chiefs who are in favor of the pipeline. And so we seem to have veered extremely off course in this discussion. We need to get resources and medicine and fuel moving again, and yes, we need to have these discussions, and we need to continue to move towards reconciliation, and we need to continue to try to settle the land disputes, but holding the country and the economy hostage is not the way to do it.
Now, for the people who are on the unceded territory, as a former justice minister, what does unceded territory mean?
Well, it means that there hasn't been a resolution to the land claims, and I'm proud to have been part of a government that settled a historic number of those land claims, and we need to continue to work towards that. But those that are still outstanding, we have to get to the negotiation table, and we have to find a way forward, because being in this suspended state of animation is not working. And clearly, things are bubbling over now, and we're seeing the upshot of that. Although, I'm quick to point out that many of these blockades, the majority, in fact, a very small number, are First Nations. They're actually eco-activists and people who have hijacked this agenda.
Now, one of the issues that you probably dealt with as part of a Conservative government in the past is the issue of water and First Nations boil water advisories. There's communities like Martin Falls and Neskatanga that have been on boil water advisories for their entire lifetime. You'd be 30 years old and have never had a glass of water. Why are we letting that happen in Canada?
Well, it's our national shame that it has happened. Apawatuskat. I also spoke with the former chief today while I was here in Thunder Bay, and we're all lamenting that fact. It's unbelievable to me that a country that has one of the largest water reserves in the world, and we have people who can't get clean drinking water, children who are subject to lead poisoning. I mean, this is a national shame. And we've talked about it for far too long, as you've said. We need to get the infrastructure there. We need to drill the wells. We need to get the actual water problem solved. And raising expectations and promise after promise hasn't been fulfilled. So let's just get on with doing it. We can do it. We have the capacity to do it. We have the resources to do it. The water is there. I can't explain it. I can't in good conscience say that we have done enough, because we haven't.
So as you're going across the country and you're talking to Canadians like you were tonight, to about 100, 150 people, what message are you sharing with Canadians as to why they should be supporting Peter MacKay for leader of the Conservative Party?
Well, I think my message is one of positivity, and we need to get back to some of the basics of ensuring that our economy is working, that we're moving forward to become a productive, competitive country again, that we're allowing people to use more of their own resources, that we're able to import and export free from interference. I think we have to reach the promise that this country has presented to its citizens and to the world. It's why people have come here. They love the freedom. They love the fact that they can provide for themselves and do more for themselves. I think this campaign, I'm hoping, is going to attract people who share those views and values. We're going to get into the specifics of a platform on how we achieve some of these important milestones and how we move forward, how we address some of the issues and inequities around water in our First Nations, but how we include everybody in the economy. It really has to be about how we make this economy click. We're living in a highly competitive time. We live next to the biggest economy in the world, in the United States. We need to have access into their market, but we're also competing with them. And one of the things that we're competing with them on is the export of energy. And yet, we're not there. We're not in a place where we're able to move liquefied natural gas that will help, in fact, lessen greenhouse gas emissions. We're going to be using fossil fuels for the next 40 years. We have some of the biggest reserves of fossil fuel in the world. We can refine it, we can export it, we can benefit from it, we can reinvest, and we can include our First Nations as owners and partners in that exercise, and then we can take the return on investment and put it into green technology. And we can improve those alternative energy sources and export that to the world. We've got great innovators. I met some of them here in this room today. It's amazing to me what some of our entrepreneurs and what young people are doing, and they're graduating from university, and yet we're not getting the traction that we should as a nation.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good. Appreciate it.
If you found this video helpful, hit that subscribe button, hit that like button, share this video, and keep up to date on what's going on.